Hello guys, and welcome back to the 10th episode of City Skylines Industries. It's actually been a while since I've released a video. The reason for that is I have been doing some updates to the channel, as you guys may have noticed in the Subnautica first look episode. You guys may have noticed I got some new transitions for the channel. I'll put a link in the description to that tutorial video where you guys can get your own free glitch transitions done. And you guys saw that I got a new logo. I'll also put a link in the description for that. During the course of last week to this week, I also installed a few mods in City Skylines, so such as the Move It mod and Find It and stuff, so we can build more of a custom city. Anyway guys, let's get into it. Let's get back into City Skylines and let's see how we can do now. It's been a while. Let's see if I still have the mindset for City Skylines back in this corner again. If you guys can probably hear that my voice is sounding a bit different. I still have a bit of the still have a cold on my throat right now, so that's why I'm sounding so, my voice is sounding so deep right now. But I said I'd still do a City Skylines episode for you guys. I did turn on day and night mode for this episode. As you can see, I have two new mods at the bottom there. So we can tamper with some stuff. We do have a high demand for industrial and commercial. So what I can do here, I can I'm thinking about it right now. All right, this is what I really wanted to fix, but I probably already did that last episode with, yeah, this is kind of wonky right here. I'm just gonna fix this quick, move it. So you see arrows and stuff. Yep, it slows down the game right there, especially when I'm doing some terrain editing and editing. Some stuff on the highways. Alright, so that's enough for Move It right now. Let's see, that is looking terrible. That's getting terrible. Oh well. Oh well. Alright, so let's be, just have to get, yes, a bit of a glitch there, usually happens. the names are kind of corrupted there. If our tourism district is going good. Farm and industrial area also working as planned. Let's just fast forward that there. And it's turning into nighttime, so you guys finally get to see what the city kind of looks in the night. So we have a demand for industrial, a lot of demand for industrial. Let's see if we can get that done this episode. So we can. What I'm thinking at the moment is continue this industrial district here across and fill up this whole area. That should complete most of the demand we have for industrial. That's the best I can do at the moment. Go like about four. What is that it's clipping to? I have no idea. Slightly grid style. The water. Oh, we already have water there. And let's do the zoning. Should take care of the demand for industrial. Yeah, that should do it. Alright, so now we have more demand for residential and commercial. We have a huge plot of land. Well, this is a oil industry land there. Got a huge plot of land somewhere. Actually, it's over the highway, so can start a district across here with part residential with its own commercial district in the corner. That could in fact work, and it's becoming daytime here. Yeah? And have an interesting connection. Probably going to work. Alright, let's see if we can at least get the line to go across. Right, and you have that go across there. Yeah, that's just my bit of an interruption there. Let's slow that down to 2. Right, so I'm thinking how am I going to get it to come across, but there's a train line right there. This is why I have moved it. So that's it. Wrong one. We're going to use the avenues. Gonna go up. It's actually working. It actually worked. Ooh, that's interesting. You can put And that makes it look a bit simple, but yet effective. And we can also connect this part to the highway. That was the plan after all. And already we see some traffic using that road. Bit further back. There's a bit of a wonky a bit of a wonky intersection there, but it works. It works. Let's get on with it. Yeah, my throat is not so well right now. Yeah, in fact, still sitting on 1 million. Wow. So we're gonna need a normal grid style most of the way. That could have honestly go on the wrong though. That'll be the residential, this will be the commercial. And let's see how we are going to do this on here. Alright, that's how I really wanted it to actually look. Going under the hill. Now for the zoning. I got some practice with my zoning recently, so it's not as crappy as it was before. I did in fact play City Skylines during last week. Currently working on a sandbox city. If you hear that, that's the wind in the background. It's really breezy here today. Another creative zone here. Doesn't have to be perfect. This is going to be an interesting one. Ooh, our ore industry. We have an ore industry. Oh yes, we did in fact create an ore industry last episode. It's been a while. Our orange industry just reached level 2. Cool, finally. It's cute. Put that somewhere. Oh wow. this connection is awkward. As I said, this is going to be a weird zooming across here. But it will work. It will work. Now let's deal with power. Might as well start that way. We can have a connection run directly next to the bridge. Yep, gotta zoom in there a bit. And we have power. Now for water. Run directly in line with the bridge. I like to have my water pipes run with the main roads and then branch them off to cover the rest of land. Let's see, who's going to get this district? It's probably going to be one of my supporters on Twitch. You guys can feel free to check me out on Twitch, where I do live streams Mondays to Saturdays. Recently I've started streaming Destiny 2. Actually did my first Destiny stream Saturday. Today's Monday, Saturday I did my first Destiny stream. It actually went better than I thought it would. Oh, we have a patch of land here. And that's a hill. Yeah, that's a hill. That's going to be really hard to get zones there. Let's get some zones down here. But first, we can have this. Let's see what this district is. Alright. The district is high-tech offices. We can have this as the fully green area. District. Yeah, we can have it as a full green district. This whole plot of land, a district. And it's turning around to be night soon again. If you guys missed the previous episode of City Skylines Industries, I'll put a card right above the screen so you guys can catch up with the playlist. I'll also drop a link to the playlist in the description and at the end of the video. So that's commercial would be green, organic. Move that please. And self-sufficient buildings. We have water, let's just do the zone in here. So this whole area would be commercial, high density. Really hard to zone these, the chunks. I'll put some regular offices on the outskirts of the commercial. Like around the main road there, I'd have some regular offices. I The residential would be full residential zoning. Yes, this is very time consuming. So I'd just skip it. Alright guys, back here, just finished the zoning. Took a while to actually do that. Now we can see if we can get power to actually connect. Let's drop some healthcare and stuff around. Start by dropping it here. We can get a cemetery right there. Crematorium right there. Fire station on the main road around there. Police headquarters around there. Now let's see how power is going. It's connected. There it is. We're connected. We should have power. And there we go, we have power across here. We can also deal with some schools. Drop a elementary school there. And one up here also. And drop a high school right here. And probably drop one on this end. Might as well drop a university also right next to the bridge. And that should take care of the schools. And there you hear the village leveling up there. We have to get some public transport across here also. Might just, yes, it's a good idea to actually, ooh, we just dropped into a minus. But it's still a good idea to drop a connection. Slope too steep. Let's see, drop a train connection right there, the commercial area anyway. Having a cross there would cause some problems, but over the highway. I know you guys may not be able to see this, but what should do for the first one, and the second one can go. Let's see if we can bug City Skylines there. The usual city skylines with the connections. I might as well go under. That's a better idea. Let's see how this is going to work. and that's where Movet Mod would come in to change that. Now that junction is just like messing it all up. Alright guys, that took like about 10 minutes tinkering to actually get this junction to work there. So we're back here. That took a while. Okay, so we get that connected, we should have this working. And keep that off for now. Now we can just jump back into that and create a line from the major terminal, which is this one here, to this one, and back. So now we have a line coming from the main train hub to that part of the city. These guys decided to build where there's no power. Let's deal with that quick here. Might as well drop a connection. Why not? Doesn't tamper with the zone. And now they should have power. So far what I can see is that this would cause a lot of traffic when trains come in. Like, well, not much traffic. How much people is on that train? None. Eventually we would see people using the trains. It's a fresh new line. So, and we are back at a positive, finally. We do have a green district across here. Evergreen Park. Forgot about that. As you can see, this line is extremely busy. Like really extremely busy. We can in fact, as this also has cargo on this line, we can in fact make a bypass for some of the passenger train. Oh my god, why can't I say that? Passenger trains. Like the one that's going down there. So just in case there's a train in the cargo station, we'd have a bypass. Yeah. Let's see if that actually works out. The public transport overlay. Where are you? There you are. And it actually does. Well, not for the line. That's very weird. But the normal trains actually use the bypass. Let's see, that's one of the line trains. No, that's a normal train going back up to the other train line way on the other side of the city. Wow. And we have some confusion. There's a lot of trains. That's a lot of trains. Wow. That's a lot of trains. Still have a number of traffic issue here. They are stopping by this junction for... Alright, that's not much of a traffic issue. Alright, since we got the move it mod, we can actually fix the edges on this, just the end of the episode. Alright guys, all you fans of the channel, thank you for tuning in to this episode of City Skylines Industries. It's been a nice episode, episode 10 to be exact, of City Skylines Industries. We created a brand new district that would be named in the next episode. If you guys want to catch me live streaming on Twitch, it's twitch.tv/ashboss1234. Again, twitch.tv/ashboss1234. You guys can also feel free to drop across to my Twitch channel and drop a subscribe if you like to support the channel even more on my Twitch channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Thank you guys for all your support, all your encouragement to continue putting out videos on YouTube and doing live streams on Twitch. See you guys later, probably a bit later on for a live stream. Thank you guys for tuning in. Ashboss is out.